Not one, not two, but over 1,000 subscribers in the last 30 days. Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. So I posted a poll like a week ago asking my subscribers if they would like a quick tutorial on how to grow their YouTube channel. And this is the result from the poll, so I decided to share this quick video. This is not normally what I would do on this channel, but since most people want it, it's an on-demand video and I'm glad to share it with you. As you may have noticed, my channel has crossed over 2k subs and it's barely four months old. Like I created the channel like last year, but I started posting on it in 2020, and in less than 4 months I've had significant growth. So I basically have gained over 1,000 subscribers in 30 days time, as you can see from this analytics, from June 15th to July 12th. It's not easy per se, but it requires a whole lot of work. So in this quick video, I'm going to show you how I grew my channel from almost zero, because I had about 50 subs at the time, to about 2,000 subscribers now. So keep tuned and enjoy the video. So YouTube tends to be frustrating, especially when you're just starting out and posting your videos and no one seems to want to watch your video. It can get discouraging and some people may even tend to quit. But in the long run, you just have to be patient and do your job. But another thing to note, it doesn't matter how professional your video is, doesn't matter how much time you spend editing your videos. Once you don't do these quick tips I'm about to share with you, I guarantee no one will see your video. So if you're excited to see the tips, I'm going to list them out in no particular order. So the first thing you need to do is to make sure your channel is professional enough. By professional, I mean you have your logo set up. You can see my logo here. You have your channel ad set up and you have your about section set up. This about section is pretty much important and most people tend to neglect it. So you need to like specify what your channel is about. Like you can read this, my quick channel intro. Like what I basically focus on is helping those without a laptop to gain tech skills and optimally make money using their smartphone. So if you let your subscribers know this from the start, people who are interested in your videos will want to subscribe to you. So you can just add in like a nice description about your videos, and this also helps in optimization, and some people don't know that. So if you would like to know how to design a channel logo, if you are just starting out and you don't know how to design your logo or your banner, there are a lot of free tools that you can use online. One of them is PixArt or Pixel Lab. I have a ton of tutorial on how to create a YouTube channel logo. I'll put a link to that in the description section, or you can just look through the screen. I think on the top of this video you'll see a link to one of my videos on how to create a YouTube channel intro. So that's one thing to do. And also, once creating your making your channel professional, you have to like optimize your channel, like adding tags about your video. We are going to talk more on that as we progress. So the second thing to do is to make sure you use custom thumbnails. Most people make the mistake of using the thumbnail auto-generated by YouTube. Once you upload the video, they just upload the video and leave the thumbnail like that. You will never want to do that. You need to like design your thumbnail. You can use your phone to do that. You can use your laptop. You can just, most of these apps, they specify like YouTube thumbnail ratio, so you don't have to like memorize the ratio. You just, once cropping the image, you just select that of YouTube. And it's also important to add in text. Like you can see this video, like just text of about 20 characters tops, like explaining in, it should be something related to the title, just so that people will know what they are expecting. Because most times this thumbnail is what shows up in the recommendation in searches, and people, if your thumbnail is not catchy enough, nobody will want to watch your videos. So that's one thing to note. And another pro tip to implement: once you save your thumbnail, if you rename it, it's important to rename it to the title of the video. Doing that will help in ranking your video better, and most people tend to upload that. So another thing to know is, my third tips for you is, do a keyword research. In other words, perform SEO before you upload video. Don't just go around creating topics and posting videos. That doesn't work. You need to know what people are looking for, know what your audience are after, and know the competitions. So let's say you want to do a video on let me say makeup. You can just search in makeup and you can see a whole lot of keywords that pop up here. Makeup tutorial for beginners, makeup videos, a whole lot of makeup hacks. You can use this to have idea on how to create your content. And once you do that, once you pick a keyword you want to target, you need to optimize your title so that it has that keyword in it. So having this, when I was growing my channel, I tend to do a whole lot of research. There are a lot of tools I use, though I use my laptop. I installed Keywords Everywhere, and you can also use TubeBuddy to do keyword research. There's also Google Keyword Planner. It will show you the search volume and the potential traffic that you can get when you target that keyword. You don't want to target a keyword that nobody is searching for. You need something with relatively decent search volume, and you also don't want to target something that has high traffic. It will be difficult to rank your channel because there are a whole lot of people already ranking for that. So you need to pick a keyword that has relatively low volume but high traffic. And the tool to help you do that, you can obviously use TubeBuddy, and you can use Keywords Everywhere. You can install the extension on your Chrome browser. It will help you in terms of seeing the tags and knowing the search volume. So another thing to do is optimize your videos. By optimizing your videos, I mean a thorough, make sure you don't neglect anything. One, make sure you have a custom thumbnail. Don't use the default thumbnail. Two, you make sure you optimize your title to make it catchy enough so that people will want to click it. Think of it this way, a whole lot of us are on YouTube, even just to watch for tutorial and just to get entertained. So just view yourself in terms of in your audience perspective. What makes you click on a video? Is it the title? Is it the thumbnail? Is it the text on the thumbnail? Whatever it is, those are your gold mine. You need to leverage on that to implement on your videos. Most people are unconsciously clicking on links because of the thumbnail, how the thumbnail is starting. And another way to optimize your title, you need to include the current year in your videos. When creating a video, let's say a tutorial on how to do a makeup for beginners in 2020, something like that, most people will want to click on that. And once you do your keyword research and still on optimizing your videos, you make use of your description section. Most people tend to neglect their description section. Let me show you something on something like that in the description section of this video. This is the wait for it to load. It's taking quite a lot of time. Yeah, this is the description section of this video. So most people tend to neglect it and don't write anything here at all. So you have to give a slight description about your video, telling them what you did and how you go about it. But you have to be careful not to put in too much nitty-gritty details about the video, because it will get boring. Most people will just know everything about your video from the description. So just adding a slight description about your videos, and also incorporate the keyword you want to target. Let's say you're targeting makeup for beginners. You add it on your title, you incorporate it two or three times in the description section of the video. Then another thing to note is these tags. These are very important. They help in ranking your videos. So first thing to do with the keyword you're targeting, that should be the first tags, the first tag on your video. Then there are other, like when we did that search for the makeup, I would just discard this. When we did that search for the makeup tutorial, so you can add in makeup tutorial for video beginners, makeup videos, makeup by Peter, I don't know who that is, makeup transformation, makeup hacks. Those are the tags you need to incorporate, because this search is here and what people are searching for, and YouTube has helped you so that you know what people are searching for before posting your video. So this you should incorporate on your tags. So I'll just show you, like, my, although there has been people have been making videos on Pixel Lab, but I'll just do a quick search for Pixel Lab and I'll show you. This is my video ranking number one on Pixel Lab on YouTube. It's not easy, it wasn't easy doing that, but this always adding that tags on your videos will ensure you rank better on YouTube. And another thing to note is, once you upload your videos, always engage with your audience. What I mean by engaging is like reacting to their comments, like loving their comments, liking it, replying. Always reply to your comments. You know, obviously, you are just starting out, you won't get a whole lot of comments. Just all of us, we are all starting out. So try as much as possible to relate with your audience, like reply to their comments on your videos. That will also help YouTube algorithm, because once YouTube sees that people are reacting to you, there's enough engagement on your videos, they want to recommend it to other people, because their sole aim is to keep people on their platform. And if your video is helping them achieve that, they'll show it out to a whole lot of people. Another thing to use is the number fifth tip I have for you today is study your channel analytics. I'll just pull up my analytics here. This tab, the discovery tab, if you don't know, and this app I'm using is YouTube Studio. It's the official YouTube app for smartphone. There's a support for Android and iOS. So this analytics will show you how your channel is performing, what you need to improve on, where your traffic are coming from, and a whole lot of stuff. So from here, I can see that my traffic source is other YouTube features like recommendation, notification, then YouTube search, then suggested videos. So here you need to rank on YouTube search. Just like from here, I can see my most popular YouTube search terms that my videos are ranking on. Once this shows you how your videos are performing, and another way to like grow your channel, once one of your videos have been proven to be performing on Google search, you use that same keyword and retarget it using creating another similar video, but not exactly the same, but creating a similar video around that same topic. Then you retarget that topic, that thumbnail, and that keyword per se, sorry. Retarget that keyword, creating a new video, and you're optimizing it. You don't necessarily have to target it word for word, but you can just like do a little variation on it. Then it will just, these YouTube analytics are pretty much helpful. Study them and know where, it will help you to know where traffic sources are coming from. Like you can see, I have external sources from Maryland, from WhatsApp, from Google, from Facebook. I'm coming to that, how I got all these external sources. If I'm on desktop, I'll show you the number of subscribers these external sources brought for me in the last 28 days. So you need to leverage on every feature that YouTube has for you. Those are the ways to grow. Then my number six tip for you is to promote your content through end screen and cards. Most people don't know that YouTube has this feature for end screen. They have support for end screen, so that those end screen, they offer you the opportunity to promote your other videos. Like at the end of your videos, you promote one or two of your videos, and also promote your channel as a whole, because you add in your videos and your channel name and people can subscribe to you from that screen, from that end screen feature. And that has brought to me a whole lot of subscribers. Like you can see, there's this card. I don't use this card often, but you can see it's bringing a whole lot of traffic. And I promote my playlist on my end screen, and you can see there's a whole lot of engagement from my playlist through end screen. So that's that about that. Always use your end screen, and the way to utilize it, you need to be on the studio official app. You can do that on your YouTube official app or the YouTube studio. Let's say I want to edit the end screen for this particular video. I can just click on this and this edit icon, and then you can see this end screen here. Just click on it and set up your own end screen and edit it. So that's that about that. I won't go into the details about adding it. You can just do that, or it's pretty straightforward. So my number 7 tip for you is get relevant backlinks. Most people don't know about this, but backlinks are pretty much important. You can see this top external sources of traffic. These are the backlinks. I post my content on Neuralink. I share my content with my friends on my WhatsApp. I share them on Facebook and all of my social media. So those are free places to get backlinks. Make use of your social media, and also make use of free community forums such as Reddit, Quora, Neuralink. So there are a whole lot of community forums you can share your contents on and get traffic. So these are my external sources. And another way to get backlinks, you can order for it. I think I ordered ones for external backlinks on SEO eStore. They are professional backlinks provider, and for as low as $1, you can get over 1,000 backlinks, or 100 backlinks, I think. 100 relevant backlinks. So they are pretty good. I've used them and I know they worked. If you want to try them out, I'll put a link to their website in the description section of this video, so you want to check that out. SEO eStore, they are good to get quality backlinks. But one way to get your backlinks are using your the best way to get it is through community forum. If you have a blog or a website, you can promote your content there as well. The next thing is to add your channel tags and brand icon. This is part of customizing your channel. Like, you need to do this on the studio app. I'll just pull up mine to show you how it works. So you click on that settings icon and you click on this channel. Click on the channel section. So here you need to add in tags that are related to your video. Let's say your content are based on makeup, if they are based on comedy, you need to add relevant tags about comedy on this basic info about your channel, this keyword section. This will help YouTube a lot in ranking your content and promoting your content in terms of searches. Another thing to note, you can get tags using Google Keyword Planner, or you can just use YouTube to just search for, let's say, tutorial top 5, and you see a whole lot of keywords you can input in your basic info. And another thing to do is this branding. This tab is pretty much useful. It's just like a subscribe button on your once your video is playing. So I use this and I set it to display throughout the video, so that once you are watching my video and you just tap on the icon, it will show you a subscribe button and it will urge you to subscribe. So that's pretty much helpful, because most people they tend to find, they find it difficult, like scrolling down to subscribe. Once they have this on your screen, they subconsciously subscribe to your channel. So you can I downloaded this image for free. You can use it. I got it from pixabay.com, and just do a search for YouTube and you can see YouTube icon and you can see it. You can design your custom icon, but I think it's best to use like something that's telling people to subscribe or subscribe with subscription related stuff. So that's it about that. The number 9th tip I have for you is to tell your viewers what to do. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my channel. Subscribe now in case you don't want to miss on any important content. And turn up the notification bell icon so that you'll be the first to know when I publish a new video. That is telling your subscribers what to do. That's what I just did there. You can use animations to do that, like adding animation videos that tell people to subscribe, or you tell them verbally to do that. Telling them verbally has been proven to work best, but you have to be careful not to spam your viewers. Like, what I mean by spamming is telling them every minute, like after a minute you tell them to subscribe. There's a way to do this, like beginning of the video, middle of the video, and towards the ending of the video. That's the best practice to do. You always tell your subscribers what to do, because most people are clueless. Let's say you don't add it and they finish watching your video, you don't add an end screen, you don't tell them to subscribe, they'll just move to the next video. So that's another way to engage your viewers. Then the last thing, to my last tip for you, my number one tip, this is the most important of them all. If you fail to do this, I bet you none of these other tips will work. The number one tip is consistency and commitment. So you can't really achieve much if you're not consistent, if you're not committed to what you're doing. You wouldn't want to be like upload one video this year and let's say you upload another video, or you upload this month, after 6 months you upload. Most people tend to get discouraged and not even unsubscribe from your channel. So what I mean by consistency, I don't mean you should be uploading every minute of the day or every day, but specifying, like having a timetable. Let's say you're uploading once a week or twice a week, or even though you're uploading daily, make sure you stick to that timeline. It doesn't matter what your timeline is, just make sure you stick to it. That's the most important thing, and be committed. YouTube growth is not very difficult. It will be difficult getting up to your first 1,000 subscribers, but after that everything is pretty much on autopilot and you won't tend to do much work on it again. So that's it guys, on my top 10 tips on how to grow on how I grew my YouTube channel from 0 to 1,000 subscribers. Obviously you have to put in a whole lot of work for this to work. You have to do a whole lot of stuff. So I urge you to put, even though you're not going to implement all 10 of these, but make sure to like try at least one or two of them. If you want, which of them will you like to try out? You can tell me in the description, in the comment section of this video, so I'll know which of them you are going to try out. And if you would like me to do like another version of this video, like part 2 of this video, you can also tell me in the comment section. From your comments I will know whether to continue on this series or not. Thank you so much for watching, and please subscribe to my channel so you will not miss any updates, and I will see you in the next one. Bye bye.